Thanks to accept make interview with the Voice of America.
You're welcome.
I want to talk to me about your name and from your coming.
Okay. You want Kurdish name?
Two.
Yeah. American name, Jeremy Woodard. Kurdish name, Sipan Ahmed.
From?
Meridian, Mississippi.
Okay. How many times you were coming from here?
This is my first time here. I've been here for a month in Rojava. I left America last month on the 14th. Arrived here on the 16th. And plan on staying here for 2, 3, 4 years.
Okay. First question, what you brought for Rojava?
I came here because I was sitting at home watching the news, reading Facebook about what Daesh was doing, ISIS, killing innocent people, raping women, children, selling them in slavery, running everybody from their homes, trying to just take over. Killing innocent people that couldn't even defend themselves. So I took the initiative, saved up my money, got on a plane, came here to join Yapege to help fight.
What did you think about Kurdish before you coming here?
I did 8 years in the army. I've been around Kurdish people on more than one occasion. I love the culture. I love the people. And felt like I had a bond with the Kurdish nationals.
And now what do you think now, you know, after you come here?
It's an experience. It's something that you can't really imagine. You have to be here to experience it. I still love the people. I'm growing a bigger bond with them, and I wouldn't change it.
Nobody can hold their grounds against ISIS, but YPG is fighting bravely, as General Lloyd Ashton mentioned offered 4 days ago, especially. How do you comment on this?
We don't have the weaponry that ISIS has. We don't have the troops that they have. But we are holding our own ground against the fight. We are pushing them back slowly but surely. With time, with the help of other countries, I'm sure 2 years from now, we'll have control of Kurdistan, Syria, and push them farther back.
Did you actively fight on point against ISIS?
Yes.
Uh-huh. Can you speak me about to
my first battle?
Yeah.
Me and my American friend, Sardar, we're in a Mosey bunker together. It was around 11:45, 12 o'clock. I spotted ISIS coming up, so we took a shot, and our battle lasted 24 hours, killed two of them. Around 7:45, 8 o'clock, we had reinforcements, Yapege, come and help us out. Around 4 o'clock, we went to a different location. ISIS did take control of the compound that we were at. 2 days later, we took it back from them.
What do you think about YPG fighters after you coming here, and especially female fighters, YPG?
I've never fought with females like I am here. YPG female fighters, they're really strong. They put fear into all of ISIS. And for the men and female, I've never served with anybody better than them. They're strong. Their spirit, morale is very high. They have something to fight for, which makes them even stronger to take back Kurdistan and push ISIS farther back.
The Turkish government is very angry that the contact between YPG and the American government.
Yes.
And that government, Turkey says that's YPG and YPG is terrorist forces. What do you comment on this?
I don't see how Turkey could deem YPG or PKK, anybody like that, as a terrorist organization while we're actually fighting against terrorists, ISIS. That's our main focus right now, ISIS. Push them farther back. America, for them helping us out, that's a really great thing, giving us weapons, airstrikes. It would be nice if they put troops on the ground. We need more people. But my personal opinion, YPG, PKK, they're not a terrorist organization. You can't be a terrorist organization if you're fighting terror. We don't kill innocent people. We don't take people's homes away from them. We don't try to take nobody's land. We try to help the good of the people, to give them their rights, their homes back, take it back from ISIS so the people can have what belongs to them.
YPG says he needs weapons from international coalition,
yes,
and the US. What you say about this? How U.S. can help YPG?
Like I said, we do need weapons. We have old antique weapons. Bullets sometimes jam, won't fire. We do need help, weapons, medical equipment from not just one country, but everybody. If everyone can actually pull together, help out YPG, or either come over here, put troops on the ground, it'll be a plus for us. I don't think we're gonna be able to get any more ground if we don't have the help. We need a unity from all to push back the terror.
That's many person and in American and the world and the all media, international media, told how why Spain, okay, I prefer name to Spain, and another factors coming from America to Rojava. What do you comment on this?
We gave up our personal lives. We sacrificed a lot. Family, our freedom to go down the road without being shot at, to come over here to help out. For me, I can't really answer for the others, but for me, just seeing what ISIS was actually doing to the people here, it got me really mad and felt like I should have to do something. I've got military experience, and I figured that coming over here, I can actually help out more than sitting at home, reading Facebook, watching the news, just getting even madder. So coming here pretty much gave a lot of people hope that other people from America, UK, and around the world is actually wanting to do something to help out instead of just sitting back and watching.
Okay. When we see on media that air forces of America give that YPG by flight the weapons and the medical materials. What you comment on this?
I think it's great. It's a step up. It's a big step up. Like I said, they're doing the airstrikes, America was, but now getting the weapons in our hands, the medical equipment that we actually need, it's a big plus. And I think Yepege and everybody else is very thankful for that. And of course, it got some people mad with America doing that, but it's a really good thing and it's very helpful.
And in the end, I want to ask you what your message for American people and the government of America.
My message would be for everybody to step up and try to help out. You don't have to come over here, civilians, just to fight. Put it out to the world that we are trying to fight against ISIS, and we do need help. And for the government, keep doing what you're doing. It's doing a great job, but please put troops on the ground.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Okay.
Navetache. Sipan.
Haval Sipan.
Sarjava.
Navetache.
Haval Shiar.